Welcome back, folks. My name is Tomasz Dudek. I'm an AWS Machine Learning Hero and a data and AI team lead at Chaos Gears. And this is Choose a Foundation Model for Your Use Case, part two. As we stated previously, an important step in building a generative AI-powered application is selecting a proper model for your use case. There isn't one model that rules them all. They all have their specializations, capabilities, use cases, cost considerations, and performance implications that you need to take into account while building an AI-powered application. This webinar showcases what's possible in AWS to help you choose the right model for your use case, because that makes a difference between a failure and a successful project. But the easiest way to start building generative AI applications in AWS is to use Amazon Bedrock. Amazon Bedrock, as we stated previously, is not a model. It's a foundation model as a service that lets you access different models via its API. It has security measures built in, and if the base models available in Amazon Bedrock are not enough for you, then there's also the fine-tuning option that lets you build your own model, fine-tune the existing models using your datasets. Bedrock is quite a simple service. Most of us will be using its Invoke Model API, which lets you use a single API to securely access models provided by Amazon and other companies, or if you do actually fine-tune model your own ones. It handles text-to-text, text-to-image, image-to-image, and more, and it's a fully managed experience. All you care about is sending a prompt and selecting a proper model to handle the prompt, and that's it. The rest is up to AWS to find a powerful GPU cluster to instantaneously fulfill your request. There is also Agents for Bedrock, a new feature released recently that allows you to define even a complex task and define a set of APIs that can be used to solve that task and let a generative AI-powered agent solve it for you automatically. Security is Bedrock's top priority, so your data remains in the region where the API call is processed. Your data is encrypted both in transit and at rest. No data is used to retrain the original base foundation models, and the service integrates with CloudTrail and Private Link to give you even more security options. As I mentioned, when the base models are not enough for you and you need something more sophisticated, you can always fine-tune existing models using your own data sets, even if you do not have large volume of data or a highly specialized team. When you do use the fine-tuning APIs of Bedrock, you are creating a separate private copy of the base foundation model that's accessible only to you, and it's not used to retrain the original base foundation models. So, what models are available in Amazon Bedrock? There's plenty of them, starting with Amazon Titan, AI21 Labs Jurassic 2 Series, Anthropic Claude 2, Cohere Command and Embed, and the Stability AI Stable Diffusion.
Hi, everybody. My name is Yuval, and I'm a developer advocate at AI21 Labs. We are a leading company in the Gen AI industry, where in our core, we have our foundation models, large language models in the Jurassic 2 series, which are all both instruction following, meaning that you can give them instruction in natural language and they will follow, and are also multilingual. We enable access to all developers and Gen AI builders through our developer platform, AI21 Studio, and via our partners, AWS. You can access through Bedrock and SageMaker as well. And of course, we also have WarTune, our award-winning application with millions of active users. And you can access our models, like I said, through Bedrock, where you can choose between Jurassic 2 Ultra, our most capable and powerful model, or Jurassic 2 Mid, which strikes the balance between quality and speed and cost, of course. Okay, as you can see here in this graph, where here you can see how to actually embed these powerful models into your product with a simple, easy-to-use SDK in Python. Okay, you simply just import it. And here what you want to solve is the problem of product description generators, where essentially every platform has some sort of guidelines and style, but for every product, what they do get is just a name and a list of very dry features. Okay, this is how the prompt looks like, where you can see here at the end, we have a brand, a product name, and just a very dry list of features. And what we want to do is to create a compelling product description. So let me just run this very simple SDK call. You can see through Bedrock, we're calling Jurassic 2 Ultra. These are the parameters. And here you can see This is a compelling product description that follows the guidelines that we provided to the model and also contains all the features that we provided. This is in the case where you already perfected your prompt and you know what to do. However, I do recommend to really test your prompts before, and you can do it very easily through the Bedrock playground. So here you can see this is a no-code environment where we have the prompt over here. Here we have very long text. And what you want to do is to tell the model to summarize the above text. And you have the flexibility. So let's say you don't want just a summary. You want it in 5 bullets. Let's just run it. Now the playground calls to the model, where you can see here the parameters that we use. You can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 bullets. Okay, and this is really just the beginning. There are many, many, many use cases, generating product description and summarizing, just to name a few. You can also extract very insights from long reports, automate customer support process, and many, many more. So I really invite you to go to the Bedrock Playground, play with our models, and embed them in your product. Thank you.
Thanks, Fox. Surely the choice will be easier now. I'll just quickly wrap it up. The way you access those models is through Amazon Bedrock, a foundation model as a service that lets you choose from a wide range of foundation models, access them through a single API in a fully managed manner. There are also agents for Bedrock that essentially enable generative AI applications to complete tasks with agent. Security is absolutely crucial for Bedrock. No data is shared with anyone. The data is not shared with the model providers. It's not used to retrain the base models, and your data is encrypted in transit and at rest. Additionally, the service supports CloudTrail and private link for even more security. And finally, fine-tuning is also an option. You can use Bedrock's capabilities and Bedrock's APIs to fine-tune models using your own data sets. And that sums it up. Thank you for having us in the part one and the part two. Hopefully, the view of Bedrock is now clear. You've seen all the models that are available in the service, and the choice of a proper model for your use case is now simpler. See you around. Mm-hmm.